Hello learners, I'm your EOT educator, Nishi. In the last video, we have seen the occurrence of metal. In this video, we are going to see the extraction of metals. So basically, the extraction of metals is based upon the reactivity series. So in this video, we are going to see the extraction of metals at the bottom of the reactivity series, the extraction of metals in the middle of the reactivity series, and the extraction of metals at the top of the reactivity series. So let us first start with the extraction of metals at the bottom of the reactivity series. As we know that the metals at the bottom are less reactive. Therefore, these metals can directly be obtained from their metal oxides just by heating. So as you can see, the metal oxides on heating, we can obtain the metals. Here I have taken the example of mercury. Cinnabar ore is an ore of mercury. So if I heat cinnabar in the presence of oxygen, mercuric oxide is obtained. Now if I heat this mercuric oxide again in the presence of oxygen, I can obtain mercury. So as you can see, mercuric oxide is heated in the presence of oxygen to obtain mercury. So if I have to summarize the process, I can say that for lower metals at the bottom of the reactivity series, the ores can be directly heated to form metal oxides, and the metal oxides can be heated to form the metal. So here I have taken the example of mercury. Therefore, cinnabar heated in the presence of oxygen gives us mercuric oxide, and mercuric oxide in the presence of oxygen again heated gives us mercury. We can also take an example of copper, which is also present at the bottom of the reactivity series. So copper is obtained as copper sulfides in their ores. So here copper sulfide is heated to obtain copper oxide. Copper oxide is again heated to obtain copper. Now let's move on to see the extraction of metals in the middle of the reactivity series. Now we know that the metals at the middle of the reactivity series are obtained in their carbonates and sulfide form. So these carbonates and sulfides have to be first converted into their metal oxides. So we don't directly heat them, but we follow two processes. One is roasting, another one is calcination. So basically, roasting is a process which is followed for the sulfide ores, and calcination is the process which is followed for the carbonate ores. In roasting, we heat the metal oxides in the presence of excess of air, and in calcination, we heat the metal oxides in the presence of limited air. So let us take an example for roasting and one example for calcination. So here I have taken the example of zinc sulfide, which is heated in the presence of excess of air to form zinc oxide. Now in calcination, we have taken zinc carbonates, and these zinc carbonates are heated in the presence of limited oxygen to form zinc oxide and carbon dioxide gas. Now one thing to note in this equation is that for roasting, the byproduct that is generated is sulfur dioxide gas. But in case of calcination, the byproduct that is generated is carbon dioxide gas. Also, now that we have obtained the oxides of these ores, we can heat them in the presence of carbon to obtain the metal. So basically here I have taken zinc oxide, which is heated in the presence of carbon to obtain zinc. Fine. Now carbon here is used as a reducing agent. So basically you can use any type of metal as a reducing agent, but they have to be highly reactive. So other examples of reducing agent is sodium, magnesium and aluminium. So basically these metals are highly reactive. When we talk about highly reactive metals, we also know that the reaction with these metals is highly exothermic. So the metals that are obtained with the use of these reducing agents produce a lot of heat. So the metals at the end will be in molten state. Now we see, if iron oxide is heated in the presence of oxygen, it will produce iron and aluminium oxide and a lot of heat. So this equation is also called as thermit reaction. Fine. Now these reactions can be used to join cracked machine parts and to join railway tracks as well. Now before we move on to the extraction of metals at the top of the reactivity series, let's just first summarize the points that we have learned in roasting and calcination. So there are three points that we have to remember in this. Roasting is used for sulfide ores. Calcination is used for carbonate ores. Roasting is a process in which we burn the metal oxides in the presence of excess of air, and calcination is the process in which the metal oxides are burned in limited air. The byproduct of roasting is sulfur dioxide gas, and the byproduct of calcination is carbon dioxide gas.